The foremost requirement is profit. Foremost requirement is profit. Profit comes from efficiency or effectiveness.
Efficiency.
Profit comes from effectiveness or efficiency.
Efficiency, sir.
Efficiency. Who gives the profit? Is it your product is giving the profit?
No,
customer,
sir.
Customer. Yeah. Customer is giving you the profit. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So customer wants you to be more efficient so that he can give you more profit. You need to be more efficient. Or to simplify the understanding, you must be, you know, professionally conduce. What is professionally conduce? Use minimum and produce more. Am I correct? Do you all understand how you can improve the efficiency? Use minimum of resources but produce more of the output. That's how your profit can maximize. That is why, you know, Japan has come out with the just-in-time concept, just-in-time philosophy, and today it is called as lean philosophy. And number two, any business should be able to create new customers. Any business should be able to create new customers and retain existing customers. Tomorrow you start a company. Do you want to create new customers? And do you want to retain your existing customers? Definitely, right? And then effective utilization of resources. What is the next important thing? You must use the resources very effectively. When you use the resources very effectively, your profit will go up. And then there should be innovation. What is innovation? Learning and growth. Unless and until you learn certain new things, you can't grow further, right? If you learn, you will grow, you will earn. No learning and no earning, because there is no growth, right? You must learn, you must grow, and then you must earn more, right? So learning and growth is called innovation. Now, how is my, and if you take care of all the four, then you will have, your products will have quality, and you will have the same products will have the competitiveness in terms of cost, in terms of delivery. And now, how is my company performing with respect to the profit pillar? I need certain number. Those numbers are called KPI. Can somebody explain what is KPI? Do you know the expansion of KPI? KPI means key performance indicator. KPI means what? Key performance indicator. Can you tell me one key performance indicator which can measure your performance during your engineering course? All of you are doing engineering, am I right? Can you tell me one KPI?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell me one KPI which I can see to understand how are you performing in your engineering course?
No, internal marks, sir. Exam marks.
Amit Kumar, your answer is correct, but your approach is wrong. Right? You are in a place where, no, the Hindi song is playing. Is it a good culture? No. You are here in a training program. You want to learn, then you have to help yourself learn properly. You yourself should not act against you. I see a lot of attitude problem with all of you. I see a lot of attitude problem, except very few. I see those very few I can name out very easily. I think it is Balaji. I think it is, who is that? I don't see him now. Jawahar, and then Mohammed, right? And few people. But many of you, you have certain serious attitude issue. See, if no attitude, there is no life. You need to understand. You must, all of you must have a very good attitude towards your life. That's why I have shown you the next book. I want all of you to get that second book also. You all must read first book, which is 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey. This book will make you, you know, understand and, you know, face any situation in life. But even before that, you all must read another book, which is Attitude is Everything. Which is Attitude is Everything. If attitude is wrong, everything is wrong. So, 2 books, definitely, no, they are going to be the 2 sides of the coin. One side is attitude, other side is skills. All of you are with me. What am I talking? Do you understand? There are 2 sides.
Yes, sir.
2 sides in a coin. Both the sides have to be perfect. One side is, you know, head, the other side is tail. Similarly, your life depends one side on attitude, other side on skills. Attitude, you must realize. Skills, you must learn. Skills you can learn from me. But attitude, you can't learn from me. You have to build yourself. But you can probably read book. And when it comes to skills, again, I can divide the skills into 2. One is skills for personal success. How to move with the people, how to be in a family, how to be a good, you know, son or a daughter to our parents, how to be a good husband, how to be a good wife, and all those things, you know, are important. These are all skills, personal skills needed for, you know, for success in your personal life. Similarly, you require set of skills for your professional success. These are almost same because I will use them in a particular way in my personal life. I will use the same thing in a particular way in a professional life. Stephen Covey has identified 7 such skills. From proactiveness to sharpening the saw. That's all. Read that book. You will be successful in personal life as well as professional life. All the tools I am teaching are nothing but, you know, improving your 7 skills. But even before that, you must correct your attitude. Your attitude should allow you to progress. Your attitude should allow you to progress towards success. You can't have 2 desires which are completely opposite to each other. No, you can't have 2 desires completely opposite to each other. You want to listen to me, at the same time you want to listen to a movie also. Do you understand? Both are completely against. Yes or no? Either you listen to me or you listen to the song. You enjoy the song or you enjoy the learning. And you can't have 2 contradictory goals. And this is also included in Stephen Covey's book. You must synergize. He's saying synergize. And in operational excellence, we are also saying synergize. What is the word we use? We use systems approach. Everything I do should perfectly align. Right. So in order to measure the profit, financial KPIs. But Amit Kumar's answer is good. He is really, you know, intelligent. He said, sir, look at my marks. My marks will speak about my performance. You look at my marks. Yes, I agree. Similarly, what is that I can look at to understand how your company is performing? Those are called financial KPI. And similarly, how your customers are, you know, happier. If your customers are happier, where it will reflect? Whether the students are happy in your institution, I want to understand. Where can I understand? Right? For that, I need customer KPI. I need customer KPI. And then, lot of resources in the company, so much investment, crores, millions of crores of, you know, money in dollars is invested. How those resources are utilized, that will reflect in process KPI. And now, is that people are continuously learning? Why we should continuously learn? only when I continuously learn, I can continuously perform better than my competitor. Am I correct? So there are certain KPI called learning and growth KPI. Now, can you give me one example for a financial KPI? Can you give me one example for a financial KPI? Come on. Is it financial KPI are important in our family also? Monthly income. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
How much our parents are earning every month? Our parents are earning 20,000 rupees. Our parents are earning 2 lakh rupees. So financial KPI, we must limit our expenses within 2 lakhs. So financial KPI, can somebody read out the financial KPIs? One of you please read out the financial KPIs.
Revenue, expense, ROI, net income, cost of goods sold, day sales outstanding.
Do you all understand everything? Revenue, do you know what is revenue? You know what is revenue? See,
yes, sir.
Very good. See, say something, yes or no. I want to hear that noise. Make lot of noise yourself, but don't play songs for that matter, right? You can make lot of noise, but I will allow you to play the songs during tea break, right? We'll have time for that. Revenue means the total cash inflow. Revenue means the total cash inflow. Revenue is different, profit is different. Expense, how much I spend. ROI, return on investment. I spent 100 rupees, but after 1 year, I get only 10 rupees. So what is the return on investment? Only 10%. Still 90% of my investment is not recovered. So this is return on investment. So likewise, you need key performance indicators. Now for customer KPIs, the metrics are CSAT score. You know what is CSAT score? Customer satisfaction score. Revenue per customer. Net promoter score, NPS. These are all customer KPIs. Similarly, process KPIs. Operational efficiency, lead time, inventory level, rejection level, acceptance level. These are all process KPI. Learning and growth. Employee, the skill set of the employees in the company and number of training programs conducted, number of employees who are working in the company for more than 5 years, their satisfaction level. These are all learning and growth KPI. Now tell me, do you all understand what is KPI? Key performance indicator. Purida illaya? Do you all understand?
Yes, sir.
So an organization means if you run a company, you need KPIs. If you are owner of a company, let us say you invested 10 lakhs. You need to look at your financial KPI. You need to look at your customer KPI. You need to look at your process KPI. You need to look at your learning and growth KPI, right? Unless and until you gain strength in all the four pillars, your organization will collapse, right? See here for a company, assembly lead time. At present, the assembly lead time is 46. At present, the assembly lead time is 46. But after 1 month, they want to reduce the lead time to 13.75. And after 6 months, they want to reduce it to 12.8. And after 9 months, they want to reduce it to 11. Is it a good approach? You understand? Is it a good approach or not?
Yes, sir. Good.
Okay. So I could see the comment from Amit. That's fine, Amit. But keep yourself comfortable. That is my concern, right? I could see your reason. Good. Right. See, lead time is the time you take to manufacture and then deliver the product. You cannot consume a lot of time. Because your customer, by the time he will get irritated, and then you may go to some other company. So lead time should continuously come down, and that is why the company is trying to continuously reduce the lead time. So this is a KPI. Everything is is a kind of metric or a kind of KPI which they are trying to decrease. Now tell me, I want you to answer a question now. For everything, for every item here, you need to say whether you must increase the KPI or decrease the KPI. Assembly lead time needs to be decreased. Now inventory, purchased part inventory. Inventory should increase or decrease?
Increase, sir.
Inventory, Javagar is saying he want to increase. And now Javagar, tell me, what do you mean by inventory?
Sir, inventing means giving new futures in our products. Sir.
No. I appreciate again, Javagar, for the mistake he is committing. I appreciate for the mistake he is committing. Because if you commit a mistake boldly and then if you correct it, that will be a new learning. Inventory is not a feature. Inventory is the amount of stock you keep in your organization. So what is inventory, Javagar? Inventory is
amount of stock.
Amount of stock we keep in our organization. For example, raw material, semi-finished product, finished product. If I keep more raw material, I will block my money, isn't it? I have to invest a lot of money. Now imagine you are buying provision items for your house. We are buying provision item for our house. Tell me how much provision we buy. Do you buy for one full year? Tell me, Pa. Do we buy for one full year? Do you see anyone buying one full year provision requirement at a time?
No, sir.
No, sir.
At the maximum, how much we buy?
Mostly 1 month, sir.
Maximum 1 month. 1 month is also so high, right? We wanted to keep buy minimum. Why we want to buy minimum? Because when I buy everything, one thing is the item will get damaged, isn't it? All my items can decay from its freshness will be lost. At the same time, all the salary this I earned this month, I have to spend it. I can't spend it on provision because I have some other areas also. So I should spend less on my inventory. So inventory should continuously decrease. How many of you understand the point?
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Understood, sir.
Very good. Now, continuous flow or pull system. Pull system means only when there is a demand, item will be manufactured in the company. What is the difference between pull system and push system? Push system means I don't care about the demand. I don't care about the demand. I simply produce everything. I produce in large quantity and then try to sell it in the market. On another situation, when there is a demand in the market, I produce in my factory, which is creating a good scenario for your company. Push system or pull system?
Pull system, sir.
Pull system. So
it will save the storage capacity and warehouse and all, like it will create much more spaces in future.
Fantastic. Right? So initially companies generally they work on a push system. That means the initiative towards pull is zero. But gradually do you see they are increasing. Finally, they wanted to reach a state where everything is pull. In order to help you understand the advantage of a pull system, let me give an example. Do you all seen a coffee vending machine? Have you seen a coffee vending machine? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if I want a coffee, what should I do? I must put a coin, am I right? Maybe in some mall, shopping malls, cinema theater, you might see. When I put a 10 rupee coin, it will offer me a coffee. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. And when, suppose I want one more coffee, what should I do? What should I do?
Again, I need to put 10 rupees coin.
I need to put one more coin. When I want again another coffee, I need to put one more, you know, coin. Only when I put a coin, 10 rupees, the machine will give me a coffee. Is it a push system or a pull system?
Pull system.
Pull system.
Pull, sir.
How can you, slowly move from push to pull?
It serves on demand.
I will keep all my ingredients in almost ready condition. How? In a almost ready condition. For example, the coffee powder or the decoction is ready, prepared well in advance. That is ready separately. And the, you know, hot milk is ready at one end. Probably hot milk and the coffee decoction. And then the sugar will be given to you separately, probably. So now, you know, every time a coin is put, the decoction and then milk will be mixed and then a fresh coffee will be given. Do you understand? I keep the milk separately, I keep the decoction separately. You know why? If I mix them together, I can't retain them for a longer time, isn't it? If I mix them together, it becomes a coffee. And then if I keep the coffee for a longer time, then its freshness will start going down. Customer may not feel the freshness of the coffee. So I must brew the coffee only when it is required. So I mix them only when a customer puts a 10 rupee coin. So you need to think in detail to understand what are the activities you need to do once the order is placed. It doesn't mean that you should not do anything. You will do a lot of work, but certain activities you will perform only after the order is received. All other activities I will perform even before the order is received and keep it ready. All of you understand what I am talking now? To change from push to pull. For example, I manufacture a car, a passenger car. I manufacture a passenger car. And now, the painting of the car, can I do it before the customer places a demand? Or shall I do it after I receive the order from my customer?
After, sir. Because each customer will ask for different colors.
Yes, that's a good idea, right? So do everything else. Keep your car maybe probably ready for the painting condition. And then once there is a demand from a showroom that we need 3 red color cars and 3 blue color cars. And then now you have 12 such cars and paint them according to the demand and then send it to them. Otherwise, what will happen? The consequence will be you might have produced the red color car. And like Abdul Rahman saying, customer might ask for a green color car. Where will you go? Isn't it? So that is the advantage. And now similarly, operators per shift, the number of operators per shift for a specific amount of output. Output is same. You want the number of operators to be continuously decreasing or increasing?
Decreasing, sir.
Because if it decreases, the operational cost will go down. I'm not saying that you remove the employees. No, you optimize the employees, right? What can be done with the 4.5 people should not be done with 7 people, right? So labor efficiency, you want the labor efficiency to increase or decrease?
Increase, sir.
Labor efficiency increases. What is labor efficiency? The work they are doing divided by the number of employees. If more work are carried out with less employee, my efficiency will go up. Number of parts produced per employee per every single hour in your company. Do you want the number of parts produced to keep on increasing or keep on decreasing?
increasing.
You want every, you know, the number of parts produced by each employee, this number you want to see increasing. If that means your company is growing, change over frequency, every part every week, every part every 2 days, every part every 1 day, every part every shift. You know what is changeover? Anybody know what is changeover? We talked about it yesterday.
Yes, sir.
What is that? Changeover means changing from one product to other product, changing from one shift to another shift, right? So changeover frequency should be as minimum as possible. Why? Because market is always, you know, flexible. I'm always changing. Customer ask red color today and blue color tomorrow, and then again green color the next day, again come back to red color. So it is unpredictable, it keeps on changing. So you should practice all those things before the customer challenge you with such changing demands. If it becomes a routine practice, if you are used to all the challenges in the life, you will lead the life easily. Am I correct? If your parents give you everything and then one fine day you are left with nothing, you will know you can't face that situation, isn't it? But if you go through all the pains today, even if, you know, something goes wrong tomorrow, you will cleverly handle the situation, right? So that is why, you know, changeover frequency has to be increased. And overtime, do you want the overtime operations to come down or you want the overtime to go up? Come on, do you know overtime? Working in the evening, right? If overtime keeps on increasing, will it increase the wages of the labor or it will decrease the wages?
Increase, sir.
So overtime should continuously come down. People should learn to complete the work within the working hours. Am I correct? Unnecessarily there should not be overtime. Non-conforming. What is non-conforming? Rejections. You want the rejections to come down or you want the rejections to go up?
Come down, sir.
Come down.
Come down. Change over time. You want the changeover time to come down or you want the changeover time to go up?
Come down.
Come down. Very good. Do you now understand importance of KPIs, importance of metrics while running a business? Solunga ba, do you understand the importance?
Yes, sir.
Or you don't understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So you need KPIs and metrics in any business. And see, quality is a result of two things. One is effectiveness, another one is efficiency. If effectiveness is a problem, then your product will have defects. If effectiveness is a problem, then your products will definitely have defects. If efficiency is a problem, then your people will be wasting their resources heavily. Your people are, you know, wasting the time. Say for example, in the training class also, we don't, you know, utilize the time properly. It's an efficiency issue or effectiveness issue?
Efficiency
issue. Do you know what are we facing in the training program? We are facing lot of efficiency issue. People, you know, are able to understand other discussion, but only problem is we consume a lot of time. So the issue what we are facing in the training program is efficiency issue. That means knowingly, unknowingly, we all are doing lot of wasteful activity. Am I correct? We do lot of wasteful activity. We talk many unnecessary things. What is necessary thing? Necessary thing is here, our effectiveness. We want to learn a lot, right? So if you take care of the effectiveness, take care of the efficiency, what is taken care? Quality is taken care. So quality is a function of defects and waste. Agreed? No wastages, no defects. That means the best in class quality. Do you all understand what is world class quality?
Solunga, yes, sir.
You are making me cry, right? So world class quality means no higher level of effectiveness at higher level of efficiency. That is called world class quality, right? So defects in the products will pull down the customer satisfaction. Unnecessary steps or wasteful steps in process will increase the operational cost. So operational excellence means we should correct all the problems in the company. Those are called corrective action. All the problems the company is facing should be corrected, and then we should prevent the future problem. So corrective action, certain projects have to be done to ensure the corrective action, certain projects have to be done to ensure preventive action. Corrective action and preventive action together is called KAPA management. What is it called? KAPA management. KAPA means corrective action,
preventive action.
This together is called operational excellence again. So take actions to eliminate the wasteful activities. That is nothing but lean philosophy, and prevent the occurrence of defects. That is Six Sigma. So if you combine both, you will be able to achieve excellence in your operations. That means you will be able to achieve, improve the efficiency as well as effectiveness. There are so many approaches that exist, but the superior approach is Lean Six Sigma. In this training program, I am going to teach you only the lean portion. What is that I am going to teach you? The lean portion. And Six Sigma portion, you can learn if you mature to the next level. Is it okay to all of you? Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear. I understand, sir.
Yeah. Why? Because the lean concept is easy to understand, and Six Sigma is scientific. Certain, it's a technical, lot of technical technicalities involved. But lean is very easy to understand. But when you understand lean and implement lean effectively, you can solve 80% of the problem in your company. Only 20% of the problem, to solve the 20% of the problem, you must master the other approach, which is Six Sigma. So how lean came, there is a history, and Six Sigma came from Japan, right? So lean came from Japan, and the company which introduced lean concept is, anybody know the company which introduced the lean concept? Name of the company? Have you studied in Google or somewhere? Lean was introduced by a company called Toyota. Do you know Toyota?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What was the manufacturer?
Car manufacturer.
So before manufacturing a car, they were manufacturing, in some garment industry, right? Before coming to the automotive industry, the company was called, you see here, Toyota Automatic Loom Work. And that was later changed into Toyota Motor Corporation. And Toyota Motor Corporation, that time, Ford was very famous. Which company was very famous? Ford was very famous. So the Toyota's, maybe founder, his name is Eiji Toyota. In 1950, he went to Ford. He visited Ford. Why? He wanted to learn from them. Similarly, you all can learn from some successful professionals. This is called benchmarking. So he visited Ford and learned everything and copied all the ideas and implemented in Toyota. And for effective implementation, he took the help of some experts. One of the experts is Taichi Ono. What is his name? Can you repeat after me? Taichi Ono. What is the name?
Taichi Ono.
He is the one who introduced the concept of seven waste. Concept of seven waste. And so with the help of Taichi Ono and Eiji Toyota, they developed a system called Toyota Production System. They developed a system called Toyota production system. What is the invention of Ford? Do you remember we discussed yesterday? What is that Ford introduced? Ford introduced
assembly line automation.
Beautiful assembly line concept. And they copied all the assembly line concept from Ford. They came back and introduced a new system called Toyota production system. It is nothing but improved version of the assembly line system. But the difference between Ford assembly line and Toyota production system is the inventory. What is that? Inventory. Don't keep more items in your factory. Keep less items, but you produce more. Keep less items, but you produce more. Just in time. Do everything in the just in time model. So they converted assembly line into Ford assembly line into a new model called Toyota production system. You know why they converted? Ford was manufacturing for a bigger customer, a bigger size of customer. But Japan country is small compared to America. So there are less people and so less consumption. If the consumption is less, why should you know have big facilities? Keep good things in a smaller way. So the simplified miniature version of Ford assembly line is Toyota production system. And this worked very well and produced magical results in Japan. The products were of best quality. At the same time, the company was making more profit, because earlier people thought that when we want to make profit, then we have to produce products in big quantities. But Toyota has proved that I produce in lesser quantity, at the same time I'll make more profit. Do you understand the difference between Ford assembly line and Toyota production system? Ford assembly line means I produce in big quantity and so I achieve big profit. But the Toyota production system says I produce in required quantity, but my profit remains big. Do you understand the difference?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And this Toyota production system is later renamed as Lean. You see here, Toyota production system is later renamed as Lean. Why? Because entire world wanted to follow the success methodology. If you are successful, I would like to copy from you. If I am successful, you can copy from me. I learned the Lean Six Sigma and today I am highly successful. Do you all trust my statement? You all trust my statement?
Yes, sir.
I did engineering like all of you. I did BE mechanical engineering. Then I did ME industrial engineering. Then I did a PhD again in mechanical engineering. What I have achieved by doing engineering, by doing a post-graduation in engineering, by doing a doctoral degree in engineering, I achieved much better than all these achievements by mastering an approach called Lean Six Sigma. By doing my engineering, post-graduation and PhD, what happened is I became a professor in a college. What happened? I became a professor in an engineering college. I became a head of the department, and I was heading an institution as a principal, and all that happened. But still I was not happy. And then I quit my position as the principal in the college. Then I'm not saying that this is all bad. These are all definitely good, but you can achieve much more if you understand the power of certain approaches. One such approach is Lean Six Sigma. Then I wanted to be a consultant, independent consultant. I learned myself a short training program that is called Lean Six Sigma. I undergone a green belt training program, a 4 days training program, and then I undergone a black belt training program, a 6 days training program, and then I have undergone a master black belt training program. It's about 10 days training program. So how many days totally my trainings? Initially, green belt is how many days?
4 days.
Then black belt, how many days?
Six
days. Then master black belt?
10
days. So totally how many days?
20 days, sir.
20 days. Today I head a company as a CEO, and there are about 20 trainers under me. How many trainers? There are about 20 trainers, and then there are certain teams to take care of the marketing, to take care of the execution, to take care of the consulting. So these are all that happened to me, all that happened to me in a matter of 6 to 7 years. How many years? 6 to 7 years, right? So why I'm sharing this with you? Just I wanted to see that you also mold yourself, you know, in a perfect shape at the right time. I was too late to realize many things. Do you understand? I was too late to realize many, many things. But you can realize everything on time, and you can be, you know, super successful than anyone else in the globe. So we will continue our discussion, but today now is the time for break. So we stop here. Are we going good today, day two?